interested in chemistry because I was always interested in chemistry. I was one of those guys who, when Sputnik went up and there was a call in the country to have people do science, I responded to that. In graduate school, I ended up working with a guy named Cordes who was a physical organic chemist or a bioorganic chemist. And those are people who try and understand mechanisms of organic reactions. He was very interested in modeling how enzymes function, okay? But in very simple solutions, and that is soap solutions, micellar solutions. So what I did as a graduate student was work out models, kinetic models, for how micellar solutions speed and inhibit chemical reactions. However, I was also interested in micelles as models for biological membranes. And I just wanted to demonstrate a little bit about how soaps function. We have oil, actually it's octane, and it is water insoluble. Everybody knows oil and water don't mix, and I have put a oil soluble dye in there just so you can see it, all right? Otherwise it would be colorless and it wouldn't look very different from water. So I'll pour it in there, and sure enough, oil and water don't mix. But if you add a soap solution to it, as you would at home with your clothes or into your sink with your dishes, you can change this. And so, let's see what happens. I'm just going to add it all right away. Basically, it is one solution. There's no longer a layer of oil on the top and water on the bottom. We have mixed the oil and the dye throughout the solution. And if this settles down and the bubbles go out, it will look like that eventually. Optically transparent, clear solution, dyes uniformly mixed throughout it, and so is the water. How does soap do that? Okay, that is, I mean, we have answers to that question now, but basically that recognizes and demonstrates the properties of soap that are different from oil and water by themselves. What happens when you add dirty, greasy dishes to the micellar solution? Is that the oil, the spaghetti grease that's on the plate, dissolves into the micelle interior where it's oily and it gets washed away. You can't do that in water. You've got to have soap micelles present to get it done. So that's the fundamental organizational form that's ongoing. What's tricky about it is that if you change the structure of that head group, you change the kind of ion that's on the outside, you change the length of the tail, you can get different kinds of structures with different kinds of properties, and we do not understand the forces that control that yet. And so I have been working on ways to understand those forces better. Here's a classical property of micelles. You have a little surfactant in there, and it makes micelles, and they're round little spherical aggregates. You add more surfactant, they grow, and they'll stay spherical. And then suddenly they will undergo, if you add enough, what's called a sphere-to-rod transition. How do you know you got that? Well, there are a lot of ways. The easiest one is the solutions start to become thick. If you think about the idea that you have very long rods floating around, they come in contact with each other like this, okay? And when they bump into each other, they don't flow so well. This slows down the whole flow properties of the solution, which means they become viscous. Okay? You can also make some, if you stir them, they'll organize into long parallel arrays, and the viscosity will go down again because it flows in one direction. Why make this transition? I think it's because something's going on here at the surface. There's a change at the composition level of the surface, and this composition here is not the same as that one. How do we know? We put our probe in here, we let them grow, and we watch what happens to the yields of the products that are formed here, and we watch what happens as it goes through this transition right here. We are using this probe for a completely different purpose. There's a problem in food science called antioxidants and emulsions, and how do they function? You put antioxidants into food emulsions which contain polyunsaturated oils. Polyunsaturated oils react with molecular oxygen, and they break down into smaller products which stink. This is basically the rancid smell of oils that have been around much too long. Antioxidants function, is to slow that process. You can never stop it, but you can slow it a lot. How do they do that? In an emulsified food. Think of mayonnaise, okay? That's oil, water, phospholipids, egg phospholipids, and some other acetic acid and some other things mixed into it and just whipped together. It's an emulsion. Where are the components in the emulsion? Well, we have a chemical method now for probing the distribution of antioxidants within emulsions using that arine diazonamide, because the arine diazonamide does a new kind of chemistry with the antioxidant, and we can follow that reaction chemically in solution and use that information to determine antioxidant distribution.